Welcome to EMO 2025, and we are here on the FANUC booth.
We certainly are.
We are. This is so exciting, yeah. Paul. Now, I've got a question for yourselves and yourself, Paul. Do you FANUC?
Well, I am today, and I guess that's their motto, isn't it? That's their slogan this week. I mean, firstly, I'd say this is the 50th anniversary of EMO, so it's great to be here. In fact, I was 50 this year, so ties in nicely. 1975.
I like that.
Which have been the first ever. But yeah, we're here, of course, on the FANUC stand.
Yeah, we are. Now, they are trying to change the way, change the language. When they're asking, do you FANUC, they're trying to talk about, do you want to accelerate your processes? Do you want to work stronger, better, faster, and smarter? And FANUC encompasses so much, doesn't it, Paul?
It does. It's about productivity gains at the end of the day. And what you'll see here on this stand, and I'm going to go on a tour shortly,
you've
got three areas. So you've got the FA side of things, which is the control systems. You've got the automation here as well. And then you've got the advanced machining. But of course, all of these come together under the kind of heartbeat here, which we see is in the centre of the stand. But you're right, they're trying to write this language, which is so important these days, because there's one word that everybody needs, or something everybody needs to be, and that's competitive. And to be competitive, you need to be productive. And in order to do that, you need to lean on companies that can offer you, you know, the solutions like FANUC do.
Now, interestingly, they have tours here. So if you want to come and visit the stand throughout the week, they're doing tours every single day around their stand. So you can really understand the language that FANUC are talking about. Now, you're going to go on a tour.
I'm going to go on a brief one. This is going to take maybe 5 or 10 minutes. But yeah, I'm going to do that with Nils now and show you some of the highlights from these three areas.
And I'll see you shortly.
Okay, come with me. So Nils, thank you very much for accommodating us here on the FANUC stand. We're gonna tour, just a brief tour of the stand. Firstly, I've got to start with this, the new control system. Can you tell us about it? I mean, it's about every decade or two that you bring out a new system. What is this and what are the differences?
Yeah, as you said, that's a pretty huge thing for us to launch a new system, and we built this on a complete new infrastructure, utilizing the highest state-of-the-art technology, and helps our customer really using the new digital things that you can use within today, like digital twin or AI thermal compensation, things like that.
What's it called? Let's start with the basics.
Oh yeah, it's the FS500iA. Which is now rolled out for all our machine builders.
And you talk about digital twin. I guess that means it's much safer for the operators. You can simulate stuff, and then the AI will give you advancements and more efficiency. Are they kind of the areas?
Yeah, well, you have different options where you can gain. It's like if you're gaining like the surface, you can make the surface better. You can utilize the digital twin for installation time to be just faster in switching the products. And as well, you have just the accessibility and the usability, which is just a lot easier.
And it's not just software, it's hardware as well, isn't it? Because the hardware, you get up to 15% energy savings and things like that.
Absolutely. It comes with the upgraded motors, our servo motors. And this will help you be faster, more secure, more reliable, but also have a lower energy consumption.
For milling, cutting, and drilling. Right, let's talk about milling and drilling. Yeah. This machine, if you come this way, Nils. So this is being launched here. This is the D74CS. First time I've seen it, but first time anybody will have seen it here. What is it?
Yeah, well, it arrived last week, basically. It's really a world premiere. This is the new D74 robo drill. It's basically utilizes state-of-the-art digital tools, like you can have a better surface, it helps you reduce cycle time, it has better thermal capabilities, and it's upgraded our motors.
Okay, so it's going to be available on the market now?
Now on, basically, yes.
And is it replacing a previous model?
It will replace slowly the previous models, but we will roll up time to time.
And when you talk about some of your slogans, stronger, better, faster, is that really what encompasses what we're talking about here on this machine?
Yeah, basically it will be better in every part that you look at. So it's a bit faster, it has lower energy consumption, it will be easier to program, it will be easier to use. So all of these things will come into the machine.
Okay, now we're going to look here at the combination, well, automation really here. We've got a RoboDrill. If we just ask this gentleman, thank you. So what are we looking at here, Nils? I mean, I'm familiar with the cobots, but what are you trying to show?
So this is basically our education package. So where we want to educate people not only on the machine, but also the combination between the robot and, between the machine, because in the fabric we see this more and more, and we also want to help our customers train their workforce to be able to control a robot, to control a machine, to bring the things together like it is in their fabric, to just have the upsides of using both.
Increasing productivity, which is again a big message from FANUC. Then what I find fascinating here is I read the name of this, Python. So yeah. I know a little bit about developing websites, but this is a language that I'm familiar with. So you're bringing that into play on your control system.
Yes, so basically this is our new robotic control system. And as you said, like we also did with the FS500, we really opened that up. And especially for robotics, we opened it up to also program it and control it via Python, which makes it easier for people who are not 100% familiar with the FANUC system to use our products. Yeah. But we also added a lot of additional features that are becoming more and more important, especially cybersecurity, for example, that we really made sure here with the new product that we are state of the art.
Okay, now we looked at the cobot working in conjunction with a RoboDrill there. We've also got it working here with a RoboCut. So are you just showing the different machining processes working with automation and working with cobots?
Basically, yes. And here are a few more technologically things in there, because normally a wire machine is quite slow, but still you need to run it 24/7. And here you can really just add up this cobot, and this will load, unload overnight, keep your production up and running. It will serve itself out of the box, and will run the machine more or less on its own, including tool changing as well as product changing.
Okay, because I used to think that you used to have to program the cobot just at the control and the machine at the machine, but what you've said to me earlier is you can now machine the cobot using the machine's control as well, which I guess gives you that element of well, it gives you that element of control, doesn't it, to be able to do everything on one console?
Yeah, absolutely, and it helps people that are normally only trained on machine also using robots. Like they can use the robot in their language. They can program it with G-code, so they can use the robot as if they would control a machine, and that makes it a lot easier.
You've got a line of cobots here. This is just showing the different payloads?
Yeah, it shows the different payloads and reaches, and because what we see is that usually the first robots nowadays for people that are just getting engaged with robots are cobots. And so if you want to get into robots, it's always a good thing to start with it, because it has like small barriers of usage.
Okay, now we go from cobots to one extreme to the other really here, don't we? Is this your biggest industrial robot? If you move this way a bit, Nils.
No, that's not the biggest one. We have till 2,000 kilograms, and this is capable of around 500. But this is specially made for gigacasting, which is a global trend in automotive, basically, which has very harsh conditions, very huge parts. And we see a load-unload operation here of a gigapart of an automotive part. And since there are very harsh conditions, we specially built this robot. It can flip over, it's very fast, and it helps you quite a lot.
I wonder what that was. Someone dropped a bar.
Yeah, it's a game over there, it seems.
It certainly wasn't being dropped out of one of your robots. Let's move this way. If you stand a little bit closer to the screen here. I mean, it's pretty fast for a big robot as well, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, cycle time is, especially in automotive, but also in high volume facilities, that's the game changing thing. And that's why we made this very fast. And it has the capability of flip over. So you don't need to go around, but you can jump with the robot, with the part, over the robot to be faster.
Okay, moving this way, but almost back to where we started. And I can't emphasize enough, the stand is a lot bigger. There's a lot more machines than we've looked at, and a lot more cobots and robots. This one here, I'm kind of more familiar with in the metal cutting sector. Here you're loading a bar. It almost looks like you're putting a part into a lathe.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what we simulate. And what we also do with our integrated vision, we check how exactly the bar is before to make sure it has the right length, the right size, its quality is inspected, and then you can just put it in and use it.
Now, this is cool. Look at this. Come here, Nils. I want you to tell me about what we've got here, because I'm seeing a milling operation happening here using a robot.
Yeah, exactly. That's a special robot with very high rigidity, which helps you to really go in hard metal parts and cut metal, and this is usually used before or after special machining to
So where are you programming this? I mean, what, it's picking the tools up, then it's doing the different operations. Where's all that intelligence coming?
Well, the intelligence is all inside our normal robot controller. So basically, it's if you can control a robot, you're able to cut.
I mean, when I actually look at this here, you're actually doing a milling operation here, but can you can do drilling, you can do all these different...
What we see here is drilling, milling, but also we cut the edges and things like that. So you can use it as a standalone, but you can use it next to a machine to just make the easier parts done by a robot to have more time on your very expensive machine tool.
How exciting is EMO for FANUC this time around? I heard, was it your president that opened up this morning?
Yes.
With some really nice words. It was, you know, stronger, better, all of those things. That's your big message.
Yeah, we are very excited because we really have a huge palette of new stuff and really state-of-the-art technology where we are ahead of the competition. And on the other hand, EMO is like the very best place to just promote this, and we have 100% match with our customers here.
Great stuff, Nils. Thank you very much. I'm going to go and find Lindsay. Nils is here all week. Of course, this stand is, you know, definitely worth a visit if it's on your list here at EMO. Wow.
Yes.
All in there. Down there.
It's a lot.
Up there. Yeah.
You've got it all. You've been.
Absolutely. What have you been doing?
Well, I've just been having a look over here, and it's talking about the servo motors and oscillation tools, and it's not just proving out what they do, but actually you're seeing live examples of what happens with the swarf. It's incredible. There's so much on this stand.
Yeah. There is a VR headset on here as well.
Yes, there is.
And there is also some software I didn't see, and forgive me, I don't know the name, but I've seen it at FANUC UK, where when you're looking at all this and you're trying to build a cell up, they can do it all. It's almost like a digital twin creating it. So they can almost give you a quotation based on a build of something in a virtual environment. And I suppose that's really where the future is. But Nils did a great job on the tour. So
he did. Stronger, better, faster, smarter is exactly what FANUC is saying. Now, like we've said before, you can have a tour when you come to the stand, and they're holding them every day at 11, 2 and 4 o'clock. But I've got some facts that I want to tell you. There are over 40 million products, FANUC products, out in market at the moment.
Incredible. 40 million.
Yes.
That's unbelievable, isn't
it? Isn't that incredible?
I was trying to associate that with someone's wealth, but I don't know who's got 40 million pounds.
I'm sure someone on this planet does.
Not me.
They've got over 10,000 employees, and they operate out of 100 countries. That just shows the size and the power that this brand has, and that is exactly why they're saying, do you FANUC, talking their language.
Absolutely. And this is the first, of course, of many live streams that we're going to be bringing to you this week here at EMO 2025. So keep tuned to the MTDCNC channel to catch up with all the latest from here in Hannover. I was going to use that mirror then just to check my hair on the floor.
Well, what a stand. Yeah.